You are listening to the Beloit Podcast.
Welcome back to the Beloit Podcast. The list of famous music artists and groups to pass through Beloit is truly significant. In most recent history, starting in 1988 through 2013, Beloit Riverfest brought us big-name artists like Ray Charles, Little Richard, Cheap Trick, Johnny Cash, Styx, Kool & the Gang, Alice Cooper, so many more. Beloit's Club Pop House brought a wave of artists in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, such as Del Shannon, Bobby Vinton, Zagger and Evans, The Buckinghams, The Kingsmen, Ronnie Dio and The Prophets, and The Night Trains featuring Boz Scaggs and Steve Miller. Cheap Trick played Waverly Beach more than a few times in the 1970s, also Ted Nugent and the Amboy Dukes, Gordon Lightfoot, REO Speedwagon, and 38 Special. And that's only some in the 1970s. The Beloit College Fieldhouse has seen its share of artists and groups, including Louis Armstrong, Ella Fitzgerald, Duke Ellington, Cream, and the Jefferson Airplane. Beloit has certainly seen its fair share of music artists. In fact, many lifelong Beloiters would say music is one form of art that has an unmistakable place in local history. American singer and songwriter, multi-instrumentalist, composer, filmmaker, and band leader Frank Zappa might have not blended in well with the pop house scene, possibly Waverly Beach, mainly due to the distinct music style of avant-garde rock blues doo-wop. Instead, on October 24th, 1970, Zappa and the Mothers of Invention would play at the Beloit College Fieldhouse for the Mothers of Invention reunion tour. By the time of the Mothers Invention reunion tour in 1970, some of the original members of the lineup had been replaced. The short-lived 1970 Mothers of Invention reunion lineup consisted of Ainsley Dunbar on drums, George Duke on piano, keys, and trombone, Ian Underwood on organ, keys, and guitar, Jeff Simmons on bass and vocals, Flo and Eddie, aka Howard Kalin and Mark Volman of the Turtles, on lead vocals. A 2011 online report from contributor Bailey Lewis Davis at The Roundtable gives one account of the live performance at the Beloit College Fieldhouse, saying that it was only $3 to get in. They goofed around for about an hour, complaining about being in Beloit. Apparently, the band made a scene at the Holiday Inn later. When it came down to music, it became serious. They played three solid sets, each 45 minutes long. Very impressive. Other reports say Zappa stayed at Beloit's Holiday Inn, where possibly he may have contributed to some additional shenanigans. And it's interesting to note that while Zappa was having a good time in late October during his visit to Beloit, only a few months later, he would face one of the worst moments of his career. The reunion version of the Mothers existed in 1970, but ended in January of 1971 when Zappa was nearly killed by an audience member during a concert at the Rainbow Theater. An upset member in the crowd pushed Zappa, who, as a result, fell off the stage and landed on the concrete floor orchestra pit 15 feet below. A week prior to this event, a fan fired a gun during the band's performance at Montreux Casino in Geneva, Switzerland. Coincidentally, the venue's heating system blew up, starting a fire that would engulf the band's instruments, injuring several people, and burnt the venue to the ground. These two back-to-back incidents affected the band deeply. Following the Rainbow Theater incident that left Zappa in a wheelchair, the Mothers of Invention had to cancel their live performances and couldn't hit the road for 6 months. More uniquely, the gun incident at Montreux would inspire the rock group Deep Purple to write and record one of the most popular songs in rock history, Smoke on the Water. In December 1970, prior to his injury, in an interview with Seed magazine, Zappa told the reporter, "I have to put out another Mothers album prior to the release of the 200 Motels album because that won't come out until next Christmas. It's probably going to be a live thing. I've recorded a concert in Beloit, which really turned out groovy." Some of the songs that may have been heard at the Beloit College Fieldhouse on October 24th, 1970 include the Sanzini Brothers, a cover of Dr. John's Griscris, Paladin Routine No. 2, King Kong, and Beloit's Sword Trick. 2020 saw the release of five new Zappa projects: Zappa, the Original Motion Picture, Halloween 81, A Very Zappa Birthday, and The Mothers 1970, which included the never-before-released track Beloit Sword Trick. According to a blog post from Fridays with Fred at Beloit.edu, some remember Zappa joking that the word Beloit is the sound a quarter makes when you drop it into a toilet bowl. Zappa was known for his odd sense of humor. He was also known to record and produce most of his own music, leaving a small possibility that a full live recording from Beloit was actually in the works at one point in history. If you have a Beloit story to share, please email thebeloitpod@gmail.com, and thanks for listening.
My dad made it.